Hi, my name is Lisa Balsero with USF Health. Thank you so much for joining us today. This month is National Awareness Month for Birth Defect Prevention. And I'm here with Dr. Sarah Obican. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Great. So, Dr. Obican, obviously a lot of birth defects are unexplainable, but there are some that are preventable. Could you tell us about the conditions you see that we could prevent?
Yeah, so I always talk to my patients about things that we could do to prevent the birth defects. In fact, there are things that are associated with diabetes in pregnancy. Uncontrolled diabetes and excessive glucose in the body can cause things like spinal defects and head defects and facial deformities, heart defects, and really having that under control decreases that risk significantly. There are other things such as metabolic disorders like phenylketonuria or PKU that if it's unbalanced in the body and it's not treated during the pregnancy and during the child's initial lifetime, it really can affect the baby and have mental developmental delays.
Okay, and what about hereditary concerns we should look into or be aware of?
That's right. So there are a lot of birth defects that are genetic in nature. We're learning so much more now as new technologies are coming out and finding out what are the causes of birth defects. But some things are also hereditary, which is a form of a genetic issue, which means that it runs in families. So there are some heart defects that runs in families. For example, if a mom has a heart defect, the baby has a higher chance of having one as well. Same thing if the siblings were affected. So when we have patients like that, then we talk about those risks and screen those patients for these issues.
That's good. So if you're planning pregnancy or planning to have a baby, what are some things you can do to really take charge yourself to maybe stop doing or add to your lifestyle?
Yeah, so that's a great question. Some of the easy things we don't even sometimes mention, but they're really of the utmost importance. For example, not smoking. Smoking increases the risk of poor pregnancy outcomes and having a preterm delivery and can increase the risk of some of birth defects as well. Same thing for alcohol. No amount of alcohol is safe during the pregnancy, and so we do not recommend doing that during the time of conception and pregnancy. And it can cause things like fetal alcohol syndrome, which is associated with birth defects and heart defects and so forth. And so we encourage patients to not do that. Some things that are easy to do is to actually take folic acid. I mean, we recommend taking about 400 micrograms of folic acid. It's part of a prenatal vitamin that is used to decrease the risk of having a neural tube defect, even some facial defects and some heart defects.
Gotcha. And you're part of the Fetal Care Center at USF in Tampa General.
Yes.
And Mother to Baby is a virtual center. Could you tell us about sort of the team that's involved and everything?
Yes, we have a wonderful team. We are part of Mother to Baby Florida at USF, which is a live center, like an actual center, as well as a virtual center. So we see patients one-on-one to discuss risks and benefits of some of the exposures of pregnancies, which can include radiation or infection and medication exposures. We do a personalized risk assessment for patients, and they can see that in consultation with other providers. Our team is really comprised of maternal-fetal medicine subspecialists, a wonderful genetic counselor and nursing team, lactation specialists. We all work together to kind of take care of our patients.
Excellent. And then lastly, some of the advancements in technology. Obviously, we talk about a lot of different fields and services, and it seems like it's ever-changing. How is it helping your area?
One of the things I think that's going to be a tremendous benefit for us is that we're finding so much more in terms of genetics. And genetics in terms of a field is really exploding exponentially. I think the things that we'll find out in the next few years will change how we take care of patients in a very positive way.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for your time today, Dr. Obican.
Thank you very much for having me.